can actually use my father's razor and shave. And he always used a Gillette. So it almost seemed like obvious that I would grow up and just use, you know, his razor. So I think it's a fantastic initiative because it recognizes that relationship, it recognizes that bond, it recognizes so many things, you know, about a father-son relationship.
Your question, Mandira, my father has been definitely very inspirational and has been a role model for me. I kind of try to emulate him in every possible way and try to, you know, walk along his footsteps. There are so many things that I've imbibed from him and learned from him, and I wish some of the qualities that he has, I have, and I can pass them on to my son.
Most important thing is that you have to lead from the front, and you have to set.
Spoken like a true cricket fan.
Yeah, and you have to lead from the front, and you have to set an example, a very good example. I mean. The most important thing is that I believe, and I firmly believe, that you cannot possibly love anybody whom you don't respect. First, you have to, you know, get the respect from the children for you to for them to love you. And then when they love you, you can ask them so many things, and they will, you know, obey all those things. And then Rana Jatao, while he was growing up, he was about 8 years old. So he was interested in cricket and he was interested in singing also. So yeah, advance. So I took him to Khar Gymkhana, and I've got I used to have a lot of friends there, and I introduced them, and I wanted him to be a cricketer. And after a few days practice, and we have kept a singing master also, music master, and he was learning to sing also. One day I was sitting with my drink and he came and said, "Daddy, what do you think I should take up as a career?" I said, "Singing or cricket?" I said, you should take up cricket. I said, "Have you seen me batting?" I said, "No, I have heard you singing."
When it comes to my dad, yes, I am a little bit protective because right from the age when I started even going to school, everything has been first with my dad because I was the only kid in the family, and more than my mom was a working lady. My dad was with the government, was a government employee, so he was able to spare everything for me. In the sense, he used to take me to school, used to drop me at school, pick me up back, take me to cricket classes. Including matches, he used to stand straight in front of the side screen and watch the game right from the start to the end. So his commitment towards his son, more than making me into anybody, like a cricketer or a student or an engineer or whatever it is, He was very, very particular that I was brought up in the right fashion.
I think most of the things that define a good human being, I think he gives it a lot of priority, and he expects a lot of that to be followed by his kids. And actually, not out of any force, more like of him being a role model and seeing it happen and seeing the benefits of that. Because he genuinely believes that, you know, sometimes there are quick roads to certain things, but the take the longer route, it'll probably be the happier way to go. So that's something that there's not a quick fix to anything.
You just have to leave them alone. As you cannot plan the growth of a tree, it grows on its own. But only thing is that when I see something wrong, then I will tell them. When I see registered something, that is the only thing. I have never interfered with their personal life, with their emotional life, and with their married life. I have allowed them. I have never put them, while growing up, into any pressure, okay, you have to do like this, or you have to come first, or you have to play cricket like this and all that. But I started shaving regularly when I came to Bombay. And these people, my children, have done everything, every possible thing what I have done. So after that, so, you know, growing up, like they wanted to play cricket, like they were all shaving also.